And it's the last part, part D. And this is a perfect demonstration of why I tell my kids not to give up on the free response questions. Something in a part of a question may spark an idea to do another part of a question, or like in part D, it just takes a completely different direction. Now, I left some words out of the original problem, question two, like the fact that there were researchers measuring the number of plankton, of course. So these researchers are on a boat, and it is moving on the surface of the sea. At time t is greater than or equal to zero, the position of the boat is, well, some point, but you see here where it's x of t and y of t. The position of the boat is given as basically a pair, the motion of the boat is being described by, and thus the position is being described by, a pair of parametric equations, where the derivative of x of t is equal to 662 times the sine of 5t, and y prime of t is equal to 880 times the cosine of 6t. Time t is measured in hours, and x of t and y of t are measured in meters. Find the total distance traveled by the boat over the time interval, where t is on this closed interval from 0 to 1. So basically, we're going to be looking at how much the boat moved, say basically in the first hour that they started measurements. All you have to do to answer this question correctly is remember the formula for arc length of a parametric curve. And that arc length is equal to the definite integral from a to b of the square root of the derivative of x with respect to t squared plus the derivative of y with respect to t squared dt. Okay, well, we want that arc length between the time period of 0 to 1, and we have our x prime here of 662 times the sine of 5t squared. We have the derivative of y with respect to t, 880 cosine of 56t squared dt. Just get that typed into your calculator correctly, and when you do, you're going to get the fact that that is equal to 757.465. It didn't say sort of like interpret and use improper units of measure, but they're always going to be looking for that on the AP test. So make sure that you put what this means in the context of the problem. The research boat moved 757.465 meters. I'm even going to caution saying within the first hour. Be specific. Maybe, I don't know, for some reason time zero is not sort of the initial time, but between the time periods or when t was greater than or equal to zero and less than and equal to 1 hour. Let me just make sure I'm happy with that. Perfect. And that is number two from the Calculus BC exam 2018. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework. For part D, we have another numerical integration, so math, numerical integral. This time it's going to be from 0 to 1. These functions are not stored, so second square root, that first function plus the second function squared, or derivative, and we're integrating, of course, with respect to x, and getting the wrong answer. Well, that would explain it. I missed the 8. There we go. So when that time period from t equals 0 to 1, that boat traveled 757.456 meters.